गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मैम मीनाक्षी, DGT SST इन सूरज स्कूल रेवाड़ी। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन अ चैप्टर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी क्लास 8। द टाइटल ऑफ द चैप्टर इज लैंड सॉइल एंड वाटर रिसोर्सेज। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द लैंड एंड लैंड यूज पैटर्न, सॉइल प्रोफाइल एंड टाइप्स ऑफ सॉइल, वाटर रिसोर्सेज इन इंडिया। लैंड इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट नेचुरल रिसोर्स फॉर ह्यूमन एज ही लिव्स ऑन इट and all his needs are fulfilled from the land. Land has varied uses. Generally, the land is used by man for agriculture, forest, construction of houses, grassland, mining, construction of roads and railways, etc. And it is termed as land use pattern. Soil is formed by the weathering of rocks, which takes place over millions of years. Hence, we can say that soil formation is a slow process. Soil formation takes place in different layers, namely topsoil, subsoil, partly weathered rock and parent rock. The topsoil is rich in humus and supports all types of vegetation. Subsoil consists of sand, silt, clay and holds moisture. Soil formation depends upon several factors like the nature of parent rock, the topography, the climate. Parent rock determines the color, the texture and mineral composition. The next topic of the chapter is the classification of soil. The soils are classified on the basis of color, texture, fertility, mineral content, etc. In India, mainly we have six following types of soils. The first is alluvial soil. Alluvial soil are formed by the deposition of sediments brought down by river. They are very fertile. In fact, we can say the alluvial soil is the most fertile soil in the world. Black soil are formed from the weathering of igneous rocks. They are found in the northern western parts of peninsular plateau, especially in the states of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and parts of Andhra Pradesh. Cotton grows best in this soil. The next type of soil is red soil. It is derived from the weathering of igneous and metamorphic rocks. They are confined to the southern and eastern parts of the peninsular plateau. They are rich in iron compounds. They appear in red color because of the presence of oxide. Laterite soil are found by intense leaching in the tropical regions due to heavy rainfall. So, in this way, this soil is very infertile. Desert soils are found in the parts of Rajasthan and Gujarat. They lack moisture and humus and are less fertile. But irrigation facility can make the soil fertile to some extent. The last type of soil is mountainous soil. It is found in the Himalayan regions and on the hill slopes with forest vegetation. This soil is formed due to the decaying of the organic matter. This soil is rich in humus but less fertile. Soil is the most important natural resource for man as he is directly or indirectly dependent on it. Soil needs to be conserved for sustained productivity of food grains. There are many methods of soil conservation. The first is afforestation. Planting of trees on wasteland is called afforestation. Afforestation land is helpful in the preservation of the topsoil. Contour ploughing. Cultivation along the contour lines instead of up and down the slope will reduce the force of running water down the hills and reduce soil erosion. And the next is terrace farming. Cutting down of hills slopes into terraces or stops will retard the flow of running water. Water is one of the most important natural resources as the existence of life depends on it. About 71% of the total Earth's surface is covered with water. 97% of this water exists in oceans and seas and it is saline, making it unfit for drinking and agriculture. The remaining only 3% is fresh water, out of which only 2% exist in frozen form as glaciers and ice caps. Water cycle refers to the continuous movement of water between hydrosphere, atmosphere and lithosphere in which water changes its physical state. However, the total amount of water on the Earth's surface remains the same. We use water for drinking, washing, agriculture, industry, construction and electricity generation. Water resources are not distributed evenly on the Earth's surface. The quantity of available water varies from region to region and from season to season. With a growing population, the demand for water is rapidly increasing for growing crops, rapid urbanization, and for satisfying individual needs. India is an agriculture-based country and needs water to irrigate the farms. The water resources include rivers, monsoon rainwater, and groundwater. Rivers are mainly of two types. One is perennial rivers and the other are seasonal rivers. Perennial rivers are the rivers which flow all around the year, and seasonal rivers are the rivers which do not flow all around the year because they are water fed in the rainy season only. Conservation of water resources. Due to the scarcity of fresh water, there is a need to conserve this precious resource and improve its quality. We can achieve this by not wasting water and using it in a planned manner. Waste water should be reused and stored for use in the dry season. Water must be diverted from the surplus regions to regions having a shortfall. Rainwater harvesting, in which rainwater is collected and stored for use in the dry season. It should be done to save water. Canals running through fields should be properly lined to prevent water from seeping. Drip to trickle irrigation should be used in dry regions to save water. So at the end, we can say that we should conserve water because it is very precious. So let's end the chapter. Thank you, students.